No. Wow, I'm a little surprised. I thought more people were going to be in favor of the sling. I thought you guys were going to do the David and Goliath business. I thought you were like, this is a good way to avoid this fight. Little dubstep here. All right, so we got 3 votes for use sling, 4 votes for not use sling. That's a nice Hamlet quote. Kill, I like it. From To Be or Not To Be. Get him between the eyes. Mining says sling. All right, so we got 4-4. We got 4 votes for sling, 4 votes for no sling. If we die, I'm blaming the non-sling peeps. Says Jedi. All right, got 4 for use sling, 4 for no sling. Other votes. This reminds me a little bit of Shadow of the Colossus music right here. If we die, I'm blaming the slingers. All right, we need someone to break this tie, people. We got 4 votes in favor, 4 votes against. Gemin Law says sling. All right, 5 votes for sling, 4 votes for don't. All right, anyone else? Going once. Going twice. Even working with this dreadful delay. And all right, girls are watching. Okay, you place an you could be a friendly giant simply because of what he is. It's true. You place an iron ball in the sling and twirl it around your head before releasing it at the frost giant. Rovina says sling as well. Okay, Kilobyte, you must roll 2 dice. Tell me if the number of the total is the same or less than your skill score. In answer to your question, yes, it's pretty likely that's going to happen. That's what happens when you have a skill of 12. But still. So you do one of these. What's up, Lunar? Good to see you, man. Time to roll those dice. Let's see those dice, Kill. Please. Six, so less. Okay, on the 2 dice with a 6, yes. The iron ball flies through the air and hits the frost giant in the temple. His huge frame crumples to the floor like a house of cards. As he falls to the ground, he says, I wanted to give this to you and my family. No, I'm just kidding. He doesn't say that. The wooden chest he was lifting breaks open, spilling its contents. Inside, you find 3 ornate rings, a cracked bottle which emits a sweet-scented odor, and a carved runic stick. You take the carved runic stick. Not runus, but runic stick. But you also have these 3 rings and you have this cracked bottle. So let me take that. Okay, so those things you just take automatically. Now the question is, the sweet scented odor. Okay, now the 3 rings. Now the question is, do you wish to try on any of the rings or not? Do you guys want to try on any of the rings or no? Do you guys want to try on the rings or not? They look fabulous. Yes. It does say about what they look like. If you guys decide to try them on, I'll tell you the different choices. One might be a ring pop. Do it. Nice. Inspect the rings first. Okay. Ring is not something to be traveled with. There's only one Lord of the Rings. Only one who can bend them to his will. And he does not share power. Yes. Okay. Having rubbed the bottle and sniffed your fingers, you decide that it's only perfume inside. You examine the three rings and decide which one to put on your finger. There are three rings: gold, silver, and copper. So, will you put on the gold ring? The silver ring? Or the copper ring? And no big deal, guys. Just remember, like, Indiana Jones and the Search for the Holy Grail, the Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade, it wasn't like the guy who chose the wrong grail had anything bad happen to him, so it's fine. The Corrupted Hobbit is precious. Put on all the rings. Okay, so let's see. We have a vote for copper, copper. You will have a chance to try on the other rings if you wish as well, but you may, you know, decide to or not based on what happens. Two votes for silver, two votes for copper. Zero says silver, Arcade says copper. Okay. Glob says silver. Mining says silver. Five votes for silver, three votes for copper. Warp says silver. All right. Jam and Law says copper. Six votes for silver, four votes for copper. Man, people really do want this. Look at that beautiful rainbow of names. I love it. We may have a chance if our finger doesn't melt off first. Silver is mid-tier, less likely to be cursed, and also less likely to be junk. Yeah, no gold love. I noticed that. No love for the gold. Nice. All right. Six votes for silver, four votes for copper. Going once. Going twice. I'm going to close this vote down in just a second. Okay, and looks like silver ring is it. Okay, you are now wearing a ring which drains your life force. You must roll one die and deduct the number from your skill score, then roll two dice and deduct the total from your stamina score. So do that first, before I tell you what happens next. So you have to roll one die and deduct it from your skill score, and then roll two dice and deduct it from your stamina. Pretty much, Graydon. Oh my god! Ding, 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 ding. Oh my gosh. Now, the good news is your Sword of Speed gives you plus one to your skill. So you actually have an eight, but oh my gosh. Who curses the Silver Ring? They expected it. They expected it. They knew you were going to have that happen to you, man. Oh my gosh. YOLO. Nothing at all like the Last Crusade. It was all part of their master plan, Glob. Oh, man. If you are still alive, and you are, you pull the cursed ring off your finger and crush it beneath your foot. If you have not done so already, you may either put on the gold ring or the copper ring. Well, the good news, guys, is that you can, actually. You can do that. So... there we go. So now, guys, gold ring or copper? Yeah, it's hard to see how it could be worse. I mean, all right, gold or copper? What's it going to be, guys? Ah, that's true, Glob. That's thinking positively. Those boots are like... okay. Hillness has got one vote for copper. Kilobyte says copper. Zero says gold. Graydon says gold. Ravina says gold. Arcade says copper. Epidemic says copper. Warp says gold. Four for copper and four for gold. Gold, and if they're both cursed, then I'm done. It would be funny if all of these are cursed. You're just like, God, son of a... yeah. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Seven gold. Seven gold, four copper. Okay. Make me rich, gold. Okay. All right, looks like you guys are strongly in favor of the gold. All right, you put on the ring, one for copper, 8 for gold, 5 for copper. Okay. As you put on the ring, you feel your arm fall off. No, I'm just kidding. That doesn't happen. You are now wearing a magic ring, which will enable its wearer to resist the effects of freezing cold. Add 1 luck point. So you're up a luck point, and now you have... Our hand better not turn gold. Yes, had to. Womp, womp. All right. So, you guys now have something that's a little bit better. At least you have that. Okay, now, guys, all you have left is the copper ring. So, the question is, are you going to put on the copper ring or not? It was a double flip. Gold plus 1, cold resistance, table flip. Go big or go home, put on the copper ring. It was a double bluff. That's right. Double bluff. All right. So copper ring, yes or no? Crush it with your boot. Put on the copper ring. 1 vote for copper. 1 vote for copper. Yeah, you are really resistant to cold now. 3 copper. Hillness says no. Crush it with your boot. Copper's for peasants. Venus says yes. Zeroma says no. Copper's for peasants. Mining says yes. Okay. Silverling was cursed. The gold is okay. It defeats all logic. They knew it. They like this guy. This you got to remember, man. It was old school, right? Ian Livingstone was like, I know what they will think. I will destroy it. So funny. Yes, copper. Okay. Looks like everyone's the copper. Okay. All right. Copper ring. You are now wearing a magic ring which has the power to summon a warrior to your aid once only. Again, add a luck point. You can't do that because you're at maxed, but... So you have a warrior summoning ring. So that wasn't so bad, guys. You just lost 6 stamina and 4 skill. Totally fine. Glob's like, this is crap. Mind blowing. Captain Planet. Yep. Like, Glob retroactively goes back in time and tells Ian Livingstone, what is wrong with you? Yeah. Alright, well done, guys. Too bad about the situation with the skill, though. That could be a problem. All right. You soon arrive at a crossroads in the tunnel. So there's one room that just leads out of here. Just kilobyte for the map. There's just one tunnel going out of here. You soon arrive at a crossroads in the tunnel. However, you have no time to examine the left and right branches as a strange humanoid is advancing towards you from straight ahead. And it is straight ahead. It is strange, all right. What you see is this. Hang on a second. There we go. Give me 1 second. All right. Let's see what this is. We don't need no skill, right? Skill is for the weak. Well, you're about to test that theory. You're about to test that theory right now. You guys see this. There we go. Before you stands a crystal warrior, one of the Snow Witch's personal guardians who has been sent to deal with you. He is made of quartz, which has been animated by the Snow Witch's sorcery. Edged weapons will not harm the crystal warrior. Your sword is useless. If you possess a warhammer, though, you may succeed in smashing the crystal warrior to pieces. Now, the good news is you do actually have a warhammer. And I'll tell you guys what that is. So you guys have a crystal warhammer, and I'll show you guys what the skill and stamina is. Actually, wait, before I do that. No, that's not the way it's set up. So you guys do have a warhammer. Now, the question is, you have two options here. You could fight him using the warhammer, or alternatively, and let me just confirm. Hold on a second. Okay. Alternatively, you could call on the genie to make you invisible. Now, you're going to have to make your decision before you know what his skill and stamina is. So, you can either use the warhammer and attack him. Again, then at that point, I'll show you what the skill and stamina of the Crystal Warrior is. Or, you can call on the genie that you saved from the prism in the Illusionist Room. You can call on the genie to make you invisible. So, what do you guys want to do? Kill yourself in the warrior and give him the warhammer. Not an option, sadly. Eric says attack. Warhammer saved the genie. Okay. Ah. Killabyte makes a good point. Hillness says use genie. That's true. If you die, you'll start back at the save point without having lost your skill and stamina. Can you use invisibility more than once? Is it one and done? It's one and done, Epidemic. But it may not also, you don't know whether you'll get the option to use invisibility in other contexts. Like, you don't know. It's possible that you'll get a chance to use it or not. So, the genie, it's a one and done thing, but you don't know for sure. Save scumming, Killabyte. Alright, Graydon says, five for fighting. Anyone remember that band? Arcade says, fight. Genie says, and then use one for use genie, okay? Epidemic says fight. Alright, looks like everyone is strongly in favor of fighting. Alright, here you go. I give you, ladies and gentlemen. I feel like Die Hard. Ladies and gentlemen. Doesn't look so tough. Skill 11. Stamina 13. So, yeah. Hammer. Alright. The time has come, ladies and germs. Skill of 11, stamina of 13. Yep. Fun times, but Killabyte makes a good point that even if you guys die, you can go back to that. You'll be back at that save point. That said, well, nice knowing you. All right, the Crystal Warrior comes running in. So, Kill, at this point, you start rolling those two six-sided dice and add it to your skill. He comes in, rolls a 10, 21. You need a 13 to win. Well, that's not going to work out very well this time. So you're going to need a 13. Go ahead and make the roll nonetheless. Random number, Jesus, lend us strength. Throw the bottle at him. Sadly, not an option. 7. That's not going to get the job done. All right, so he slashes into your side, leaving a wicked cut across it. This time it rolls a 7. That's 18. So you need a 10 to tie, 11 to beat next round. 10 to tie, 11 to beat. Hammer time. Yeah, we'll do it. 8 is... Oh, actually, wait. Did you say 8? All of a sudden, I was confused. You needed 10. All right. Kaplow. All right. Next one is 7. That's an 18. Oh my god, that's awesome, Epidemic. I don't think I've ever seen that emote before. That's awesome. Okay, so an 18. And let's see, an 18. And so you need a... this one you're going to need a 10 to tie and 11 to beat. Ah, 10 to tie. Sting! No harm, no foul. His powerful, your hammer bounces off his crystalline staff. This time he only rolls a 4, stunned by your blow. 15, you need a 7 to tie, an 8 to beat. 7 to tie, 8 to beat this one. You do, in fact, damage him. Blam, you break a crystalline piece off of him. Next time he rolls an 8, that's a 19, so you will need an 11 to tie, a 12 to beat him on this one. 11 to tie, 12 to beat. Ah, 5. Oh! Hits you again. You're starting to feel like this boss is, boss-like. Oh, but he gets a little cocky. He thinks he's got his stuff down, and his glass body comes in. He kind of slips a little bit, only rolls a 3. That's a 14. 6 to tie, 7 to beat. Pick up the beast we broke off so we could sell it later. I like the optimism arcades. 6 to tie, 7 to beat on this one.
Taste my mighty hammer, Knave!
7 does in fact beat. You hit him again, another piece flakes off. He looks at you warily. Comes in swinging with a 10, oh my god, it's a 21. That means you're gonna need a 13 to tie, which is not gonna happen, but you can try anyway. Alright, still gonna have to roll those two dice to clear it, even though you can't tie him on this one. Bouncing back and forth between this and Final Fantasy VIII. An 8 is not going to do it, of course. That was not going to do it anyway. Down to 6 stamina. This time he rolls a 6. That's a 17. So you need a 9 to tie, 10 to beat this second round. This time around. 9 to tie, 10 to beat. Can you do it? You've hit him twice. Can you hit him a third time? Twelve, waplow! With a mighty blow, you slam him in the side. Glass shatters, goes everywhere. Oh! He comes back, Rah, waplow, critical hit returned. So he hits you with a 23. You would need a 15 to tie, which is not going to happen, but you still got to clear it. And all of a sudden, this music starts playing in the background. That was a good roll to work on that. Alright. This time he rolls a 6. This time he rolls a 6, though. That's a 17. So you need a 9 to tie, a 10 to beat. Situation's getting critical. This is the fight the Crystal Warrior music. If one of the dice lands on an edge, does it count as 7? No. It counts as an awesome, but I mean... Hey, Tachyon, what's up, bro? Good to see you, man. Welcome into a battle with a Crystal Warrior. Ah, 5, sadly, is not going to do it. It's the critical point, people. It's now or never. You're the best around. He rolls a 3. You have an opening. It's 14. You need a 6 to tie, a 7 to beat. 6 to tie, 7 to beat. You got a shot. You got a shot. That's a good thought, Kill. You could actually use luck to reduce your damage. And I imagine we'll probably do that on this next one. You might want to do that. 6, 14. That's a tie. So, shting. No harm, no foul. This time he comes in with an 8. Oh, boy. It's a 19. That means you're going to need an 11 to tie and a 12 to beat. 11 to tie, 12 to beat him on this one. And if he hits you this time, you're going to have to use luck to try to resist it. Oh, my God, Glove. Maybe his father was always made of stone. Or his father was made of acrylic. He was always mad that his son was made of glass. You break too easily. Oh, a 2. Alright, well, so time to use that luck. So you're going to have to use that luck. There's no option now, Kill. Go ahead and roll those dice. So go ahead and roll those 2 dice. You'll be lucky on this one. And if you're lucky, it'll reduce your... obviously, you will be lucky. So go ahead and roll the dice anyway. That'll reduce your luck to 11, and your stamina will only be down by 1 point. All right, a 7. It's too late to use the genie at this point, yes. All right, here we go. Your last chance. The final countdown. 20. Oh, God. He rolls a 9 plus 11, 20. So you need a 12 to tie. It's up to you. It's up to you, Killbite. Only a 12 will save you. Can you do it? You stumble back, blood pouring from everywhere. Can you do it? Oh, 11. And 11. Wow. Just give me a second, guys. Moment of silence, please. Sir Percy Baltrex, the Stout Blaster. It was a great run. You entered the caverns of the Snow Witch in an attempt to save the world from her domination. You thought you had the luck with you, the gods smiling upon you. And then, sadly, you met a crystalline warrior that smashed the living hell out of you into a bloody, bloody pulp. And in this life, sometimes it can be difficult to carry on. Sometimes you feel that you don't have what it takes to put one foot in front of the other and to fight the good fight. But that fight must be fought, Sir Percy Baltrex the Stout Blaster. And although you put on a ring that WTF pwned you, and then met a glass creature that WTF pwned you again, you fought that fight. And for that, we will always be grateful. We bid you thank you, and more importantly, adieu. Okay. I felt like that was kind of important. Just a moment of, you know, just a sort of moment to acknowledge, you know, what happened, basically. All right. Back to the save point we go, people. May the gods bless your soul. The story, yeah, it's the inspiration for it, Guilt. Is the inspiration, Guilt on him. So it's not directly connected to the in the story, although it's basically, it's sort of the trigger for the entire story. I haven't decided where it fits in everything else, but it's definitely there, so. All right. I feel so attached. I know. It's really difficult. Okay. So back we go to the 72, page 72. So back up to 72, the save point. And your first decision that you guys have to make is whether you want to go down. Now remember, I would remind you that everything went well with the Frost Giant. Everything was going fine until you guys decided to put on the Silver Ring. Before that, everything was fine. And then you ended up fighting the Warrior and then everything else went down. So the question is, you're back at the save point now. So do you want to go the same direction? Like, do you want to basically do the same thing and go all the way back? Do you want me to basically fast travel you back to the spot with... back to the spot with the, what do you call it, with the rings? Yes, minus the silver ring. Everything minus the gold ring. Minus the gold ring? The silver ring, you mean, right? Silver, okay. All right. Okay, so if people are generally in favor of that, let me know if people are generally in favor of that. No, that's fine, everything. That's fine, dude. All right, so silver ring. Okay, sounds good, wonderful, delightful. Silver ring was bad, golden copper was good. Okay, so assuming you guys do that, and I don't see any real objections to it, you use the sling, the giant falls, you pick up the cracked bottle, you pick up the gold freeze resistance ring, the copper warrior summoning ring, and the carved runic stick. You gain the one luck point for that discovery. And this time, you don't actually lose all the crap from that one ring. So, all right. So, basically do all that. All right, give me a second. All right, let me get there. Hey, what's up, Viking? All right, trying the rings. Okay, we did that. And do the thing. Strange humanoid, and here we are. Okay, right, So that means that you guys have gone back from the ring and you find yourself back facing the approaching humanoid. Before you, I'm sure you're going to be not shocked to hear, stands a crystal warrior, one of the Snow Witch's personal guardians who has been sent to deal with you. He is made of quartz, which has been animated by the Snow Witch's sorcery. Edged weapons will not harm the crystal warrior. You can either use your warhammer to smash the crystal warrior to pieces, or you can use the genie to turn you invisible. So again, the question again, guys, do you guys want to fight? Now, this time you do have your 12 skill, but you saw he's still pretty powerful, so I'm just letting you know, but you could fight him normally now. Do you want to fight, or do you want to use the genie? Oh, sorry to hear that, Viking, but glad to have you here. Caverns of the Slow Witch, yeah. Fight, fight. Epidemics is genie. Kilobyte says fight. Mining miners says smash him. Oh, you guys want vengeance, huh? You're like, you want revenge? Use copper ring. Sadly, it's not an option, Zeramus. Jedi says fight. We don't have the negative effects. It has, I believe it was 13 stamina, if I'm not mistaken. 11 skill, 13 stamina. All Hillness says fight. Awesome. Whoops. Sorry. All right. So it looks like people are strongly in favor of fighting. All right. That means battle time. Get your vengeance. All right. Skill 11. 13. All right. Here we go. This time, though, you guys have got yourself got stuff going on. All right. He comes roaring in. All right. Sounds good, Illness. He comes roaring in angrily. And you roll. He rolls a 9. That's a 20. So you'll need an 8 to tie, a 9 to beat. Kilobyte starts with an 11. Wham! Smashes into his side. This time he rolls a 4, stunned by your attack. A 15, need a 3 to tie, a 4 to beat on this one. 3 to tie, 4 to beat. And an 8. So you knock him back twice. 9. All right. He comes up crying vengeance. Rolls a 7. That's an 18. You need a 6 to tie. A 7 to beat him this time. 6 to tie. 7 to beat this time around. Comes in swinging his crystalline staff. Six to tie. All right. So you do tie him. Shting. He comes in again. Swings around with his weapon. He seems to have gathered himself. He gets an 8. This time it's a 19. Need a 7 to tie and 8 to beat. This is reminding me of Queen, by the way. This reminds me a little bit. Does this remind anyone else of Queen? A little bit. So, yes. So you need a 7 to... an 8. With an 8, you do, in fact, get him that time. So he's down to 7 stamina now. All right, this time he comes in with a 6, 17. Need a 5 to tie, a 6 to beat. This reminds me a little bit of Queen. Gets a 10. Oh my gosh. Freaking owning face this time. He rolls an 8 this time. 19. Need a 7 to tie, an 8 to beat. And gets an 8. So you do it again. Waplow. This time he's like, over the head. 12. 12. 23. You guys need a 11 to tie, a 12 to beat this time around. 11 to tie, a 12 to beat this time. So clearly it does mean, that time you did get hit. You did get taken hit by this creature. All right, this time he rolls an 8. He's like, stop hitting me. So, okay, 19. So you need a 7 to tie, 8 to beat. Yep, not a flawless victory. Sadly, no flawless victory this time. It's pretty clear that they were intending to make this like Queen, by the way. 7 to tie. Sting! All right. He comes in again. This time he rolls an 11. Uh-oh. He's got his mojo back. That means a 22. That means you need a 10 to tie and 11 to beat. A 6. Get hit again. Yeah, so totally Queen. That's right. That must be what this is, Roix. Yeah. Okay, 6. That's a 17. So now 5 to tie, 6 to beat this time around. 12. Well, plow. All right. Yes, he's barely holding himself together. Everywhere you see is just like shattered glass everywhere. And finally, a 6, a 17. Need a 5 to tie, 6 to beat this time. I like that you're battling this to Queen. Five to tie, 6 to beat. And another 12. Back-to-back 12s? You're like, smash, smash. Victory. And down he goes. Victory. Only having taken 4 damage. Supreme victory. You own that guy. Wow. Very well done. And then you guys are going to love this. It said, this is what it says when you beat it. You step over the pieces of broken quartz that were once the Crystal Warrior and carry on along the tunnel until it ends at a T-junction. It's just not even like a big epic thing. It's just like, yeah, you step over him and he's gone. That's all. No big thing. All right, guys, you did it. You successfully defeated the guy. You executed that guy with extreme prejudice. All right, well done, guys. Okay, now let's see. Just one note that I want to make. You don't have to do it now if you don't want to, but provisions, remember, restore 4 stamina each. So if you ate one of your provisions now that you're out of combat, that would bring you up to your maximum of 20. Up to you guys if you want to do that or not, but I'm letting you know. Do you guys want to eat a provision now or not? Because you can do it when you're out of combat. If you don't want to do it now, you can always say later on, hey, maybe we should eat provisions here, and then we can put it for a vote. So do you guys want to eat it now or what? Green says eat, eat. Tekken says eat. Killbite says eat. Provisioned up. Zeramus says eat. Eat. All right, looks like everyone is in favor of eating. All right. So down to 4 provisions. And up to 20 stamina. All right. Okay, you step over the pieces of broken quartz that were once the Crystal Warrior and carry on along the tunnel until it ends at a T-junction. At the T-junction, do you wish to go left or right? Left or right? Yeah, exactly. You celebrate with a meal. There you go. So left or right? Epidemic says left. Graydon says left. Hellness is always left. Collapse is right. Jedi says right. Zeramus says left. Yes, you do have a map. Let me pop it up. Why is that not showing me? This author knows everyone will go left. I changed mine to right. Why did I not have that? Let's see. Alright, there's your map. So now you guys are at this Crystal Warrior right now. So let me see now that I'm looking at this map. Let's see. We got, 1 left, 2 left, 3 left. Then we got one right, two right, four left, three right. Graydon changes to right. Night Illness, thanks for stopping by, man. Okay, four votes for right, three votes for left in the opposite town. Because he knows everyone will go left, so... Tachyon says left. So we got four for left, we got four for right. Hey, what's up, Wyvall? Welcome back, man. All right, Wyvall, they're trying to decide whether to go left or right. Graydon has made the very excellent point that this guy has been working against normal type, which is why some people have voted right, because they suspect that Ian Livingstone, the author, is playing fast and loose with people. So he expects them to go left, and that's why he's going right. Techno Twister. Doof, 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 doof. All right, five for left, four for right. If we die, I'm blaming all the leftists. All right, going once. So we're saying left here. Going once. Going twice. Oh, I forgot to mention that the save spot, the new save spot was, where is he? Hang on a second. $148. Okay. Sorry, guys, making a new save point. Okay, all right, looks like we're going, so five left, four for right, okay, on we go, and hang on a left. Looks like we voted to go left, so off we go. Okay, the tunnel ends at a wooden door which opens when you turn the handle. You walk into a massive high-ceiling chamber which ends in a wall of ice. In the center of the chamber is an open marble sarcophagus with its lid propped up against its side. A white rat suddenly jumps out of the sarcophagus and runs towards you. It stops in front of you and starts to grow and change shape. If you possess any ground minotaur horn, you may use it, but you guys don't possess any, so... The creature soon towers above you and develops a rough white reptilian skin. In fact, he looks very much like this. Hang on one second. Hang on while I get that down. All right, let me just capture this. All right, this is what you guys see. The creature soon towers above you and develops a rough white reptilian skin. Its neck extends to support a giant head with smoking nostrils, and wings protrude from its back. Before you stands an ancient white dragon. If you are wearing a copper ring, and in fact I think you are, as the white dragon prepares to strike, you rub the copper ring vigorously. A warrior begins to take shape in front of you. Roll one die to see which warrior is summoned. All right, so, yeah, good call, Glob. It is indeed a frostworm, a frost dragon. So, go ahead and roll for me, Kilobyte, please, one six-sided die, and let's see what warrior has been summoned. While you guys do that, I'm going to put on the next album, next part of the album. A six, all right. You see a man with a large axe appear in front of you. And I will do this a little bit differently than normal. I will show you guys your warrior as well. So we've got... skill 12. Stamina 14. And... okay, the summoned warrior will fight the white dragon first. Yeah, better be Gilgamesh. All right, so the white dragon has a skill of 12 and stamina 14. The Axeman is 6, stamina 7. So you'll be rolling Kilobyte to begin with for Axeman. We'll see how well the Axeman does. Actually, wait, no, I'm sorry. You're not rolling for this. I'm rolling for this because this is not your control. This is the guy who's fighting for you. So don't roll for this one, Kilobyte. So the dragon comes in first. Rolls a 10, so the Axeman needs a 16 to tie. Doesn't get it. Next, the White Dragon rolls. Gets a 9, a 21, so the Axeman needs a 15. Gets a 7, that doesn't do it. Next time down, the White Dragon rolls a 5, it's a 17. The Axeman needs an 11 to tie, a 12 to beat. He gets a 4. Last, the white dragon gets a 5, it's a 17. Again, the Axeman needs an 11 to tie, 12 to beat. He gets an 11 to tie. Sting. He holds him off. The rat dragon comes in with a 4. 16, he needs a 10 to tie, 11 to beat. He doesn't get it. The Axeman dies, having accomplished nothing. But he did make an entertaining fight. Oh, goodness. Now, there is a little bit of good news about this, which is, normally, hold on a second here. Okay. So, yes, so the Axeman was a scrub. Now, normally, every attack round, in addition to its normal attack, the white dragon would also be shooting frost breath at you, but because you're wearing a gold ring, you don't have to worry about that. So the breath will not affect you because you're wearing the gold ring. Other than that, though, here you go. You guys are in for this fight. So there we go. All right, now Kilobyte, you are in fact rolling for this one. So he comes in to begin with a 4. So again, you guys are even Steven. So you guys know the drill. You need a 4 to tie, 5 to beat. Get down with a jazzy battle against the white dragon. Alright, that hits him. He's down to 12. Roaring, he swipes a claw out at you. 5. Need a 5 to tie, 6 to beat. Good level. All right, that's going to hit him. He's down to 10. All right. Next one is a 7. So that means he's got a 19. So you need a 7 to tie and 8 to beat him. And an 8. All right. So far, you're doing pretty well against the white dragon. And he's so far, he hasn't seemed to have gotten his bearings. He swings his tail as he gets a 6. Need a 6 to tie, 7 to beat. A 12 gets hit again. All right. He's not rolling well this time. You know, punches with a mighty fist. Gets a 6. Need a 6 to tie, 7 to beat. And you do, in fact, beat him that time. Raise down to 4. Roaring, he reaches out to bite you with a 7. Needs a 7 to tie and 8 to beat. That time you get a 4, though, and you are hit. But this time, being perhaps a little overconfident that he's gotten his bearings back, he tries to bite you and kind of looks clumsy. 4, and then he does that. So a 10 is clearly better. He's down to 2. This time around, he rolls an 8 as he desperately throws his body at you. Need an 8 to tie, 9 to beat this time. 6 is not going to do it. That time, though, he rolls a 2. All you need is a 2 to tie, a 3 to beat. Boy, his rolls have been terrible in this combat. I think he got so cocky after he killed the Axeman, he wasn't ready for you guys. And down goes Frazier. You guys successfully defeat the white dragon. Down he goes. Wablam! The white dragon falls with a roar. Intrigued by the open sarcophagus, you decide to walk over to examine it. As you approach the sarcophagus, a woman's eerie laughter echoes around the chamber, and you see this. Yeah, I know, the copper ring is not usable anymore. Yep. I'll take care of that after this one. It's so fickle, though. It's so fickle. You guys love him now. He has a couple of runs of bad rolls, and you'll be like, you're terrible. Don't ever do that again. All right, you guys see this. What's up, Snip Dog? Good to see you, man. This is your lucky gaming dice. As you approach the sarcophagus, a woman's eerie laughter echoes around the chamber. A beautiful woman wearing white fur slowly rises out of the sarcophagus, and when she smiles, you see the telltale fangs and realize with horror that the Snow Witch is a vampire. Do you have any garlic? She does look a little slow, I know, right? Do you guys have any garlic? Ah, my mother-in-law. That's funny. You have salted fish, but you do not have any garlic. The Snow Witch climbs out of the sarcophagus and walks towards you with her mouth wide open. Her gaze is powerful, and you hear a voice in your mind telling you to drop your sword and loosen your collar. Roll 2 dice, please, Kilobyte, and tell me what the score is. His garlic salt. Four. Okay. You quickly gather your thoughts and remember that a vampire can only be killed by driving a stake through its heart. Chat, do you possess a carved rune stick? Do you guys have a carved rune stick? Yes, you do. Hey, what's up, Duranker? No, not so much. You do, in fact, have a rune stick. With quick thinking, you pull forth the rune stick and point it right towards her heart. The stake pierces the Snow Witch's heart, and her death wail makes you shudder. She starts to decompose, and soon all that is left is a pile of dust on the floor. You see a vague shape in the wall of ice at the end of the chamber and decide to investigate. You see frozen into the ice wall an ornate trunk open and filled with gold and jewels. You hack away at the ice until you reach the trunk. A golden idol is the first thing you pick up, but suddenly it bursts out of your hands and changes into this. Suck it, Twilight. Bear with me. You guys see that what I'm about to show you? What you're about to see is real. The names have been changed to protect the innocent. All right. You guys see this. All right. A golden idol is the first thing you pick up, but suddenly it bursts out of your hands and changes into a golden warrior, a sentinel left to guard the treasure. You must fight this creature. The sentinel. No, I'm just kidding. He actually only has a skill of 9. I can't wait to see that when the delay gets done. People are like, what? Hacks. Oh, man.
Skill 20.
I'm just kidding. It's actually only skill 9. Oh, man. All right, Kill. Here we go. All right, so the Sentinel comes swinging in. Wow, what's up, Clumsy Blonde? It has been a long time. Good to see you, Clumsy. What's up? How you been? He rolls a 3. It's a 12, so you need a negative 2 to lose, actually. So just a 2 to tie. Go ahead and clear the roll there, Killbyte, by making that roll, please. All right. You definitely hit it hard that time. This time it comes in with a 7, somewhat better, 16. You need a 4 to tie, a 5 to beat this time around. Oh, very nice, very nice. That's cool, Clumsy, yeah. I hope it is going well. All right, you do in fact beat it. It's down to 5. This time only a 3, so 12. So again, you just need a 2. And that's definitely going to get that. So it's down to 3. This time it rolls an 11, so it really puts its all into this one. 20. So this one you need an 8 to tie, 9 to beat. 8 to tie, 9 to beat. Do-do-do. Sure. Sorry about that. Thank you for letting me know. Thanks, Sod. What's up, Sod? Thank you for letting me know. There we go. Sorry about that. All right. Okay, so that one is going to hit you guys. Okay, for this next one, he rolls a 6. So that means 15. So you need a 3 to tie, a 4 to beat this time around. As he comes swinging in, looking all impressive. That 8 is going to hit it. It's down to 1 stamina. He's all messed up, blood pouring out of various places. This time he gets a 7. That's a 16 to 4 to tie, a 5 to beat. 4 to tie, 5 to beat. And an 11. And with that, the sentinel falls dead at your feet. The guardian of the Snow Witch's treasure is dead, and you are free to help yourself to her riches, although there is a limit to how much you can carry. You decide to fill your backpack with gold pieces and you count 600 in all. However, for each 50 you take, you will have to remove one item from your backpack and leave it behind. Alright, so basically what that means, guys, is you can see the stuff that you've got here. You've actually already used up the carved runic stick. And you've used up the copper warrior summoning ring. So you guys have these three things left. You've got the sling and 2 iron balls left. Sling and 2 iron balls. You've got the cracked bottle, which was just perfume, so actually that one doesn't count. So you've got gold freeze resistance ring. Okay, so now you guys can see what you have. You got the warhammer, you got the spear, you got the salted fish, the candle, the dagger. The question is, do you guys want to leave any or all of this behind? So that you can take some of the gold or not? And if so, what do you want to do? Leave everything we're rich. What's it going to be, guys? Do you guys want to leave something behind? Because, you know, this is basically what you've got. Sorry about that, I forgot that this scrolled down farther. My bad. There we go, that's what I meant to do. Sorry about that. So you guys have got, that's what you've got. You've got the leather sandals, you got a stuffed rat. Okay, so first of all, the question is, how much gold do you want to take? So remember, for every 50 gold, you have to leave behind an item for every 50 gold. So, do you guys want to take 50, 100, 150, 200? How much gold do you want to take? And then for every 50, you'll have to drop an item. Okay, so I put the poll up, guys. 50, 100, or 150 or more? It says 600. All right, so I'm going to put, let's see. So we've got 100, let's see. So Duranker says 100. 2, 3, 150 seems to be the consensus. Looks like a lot of people are on 150. Yeah, I don't know about the consensus being 150. I think Wyvol is the only one who's got 150. All right, 100. Yeah. That would be an interesting situation, Graydon. Tachyon says 100. All right, so we got 3 for 100. Sod says 100. Final Fantasy done in the style of Mega Man. 4 for 100. Or 5, I should say. Looks like Chad is moving towards the 100 limit here. The stuffed rat, it was just something that you found on the goblins. I think you found it on the goblins. All right, so you got 5 for 100. What is the market value of gold coins? That's funny, Royce. What can you sell a gold coin for? Gold coin? All right, so you got 100. And then you got 5 for 100, 4 for 150. Going once, going twice. All right, so we're going to say 100. Now, that means you have to drop 2 items. Basically, the one thing I can give you guys pretty much off the bat is the sword is one that you can probably get rid of because you already have the Sword of Speed. So it's pretty safe probably to get rid of the sword. Now, the other item is up to you guys. So assuming that I take that out, if anyone has an objection, let me know. But assuming that I take out the sword, then you just need to decide what other item you want to remove. So what other item do you guys want to get rid of besides the sword? The first sword. What other item besides that? So I have a vote for get rid of the rat. Kilobyte says get rid of the sling. Hey, Bill, what's up, man? Stuffed rat. I can't wait till you encounter somebody in the next room who's like, I will save you and cause you to win the game if you have a stuffed rat. You're like, God damn it. Okay. Stuffed rat. Good to see you, Bill. Sword and Warhammer. Okay, so Warhammer, sandals, stuffed rat. I want a dual wheel. Do 2 rolls. What's up, Snark? So far, I have more votes for stuffed rat than anything else. Right, exactly, Graydon, right. Zerma says the rat. Now, the decision was made for 100, Wyvol. Looks like you guys are going with the rat. Alright, so... I do see a couple for the Warhammer. Haha, Roix. Get rid of the fish, it's just a red herring. Very nice, sir, very nice. Well played. Gold, Bill. Alright, so you guys have gotten rid of the stuffed rat and the gold, and you guys have gotten... Get ready for it. There it goes. Oh my gosh, look at these numbers. Look at those numbers! I'm not sure that there's ever been a case where someone's had this much gold in one of these games. So you guys now have 102 gold, and, yeah. And you guys have done that. Alright. Just as you finish filling your backpack, you hear the sound of running feet coming down the tunnel towards the chamber. You stand up and draw your sword, wondering if you can survive much more hard combat. 2 men suddenly appear at the door, a dwarf and an elf, but they do not look as though they are about to attack you. They are smiling broadly and they both try to speak at once, the elf finally taking command. You have killed her! We are free! We will soon be able to take off our obedience collars. Now we wish to repay you, friend, by helping you to escape. You cannot leave the caverns by the way you came, because the Snow Witch's followers are waiting for you, and the tunnels are alive with goblins. Our fellow elves and dwarves are battling against them now to give you time to flee. We must waste no more time. To your surprise, the elf walks straight towards the cavern wall opposite the door, and appears to pass right through it. Another of the Snow Witch's illusions, comments the dwarf. An escape route she never got the chance to use. The trouble is, we've never used it either. The dwarf laughs to himself and walks towards the wall, you following behind. Walking through the illusion, you find yourself in a narrow, torchlit tunnel, which you walk down in single file. It soon ends at a junction, and you discuss which way to turn. Do you wish to turn left or to turn right? I know. Ching, ching, ching. Yeah, I don't remember if we said the 20th or the 21st, Sod. I can't remember. We have to double check and see. I don't actually remember which one. I'll have to double check and, like, send an email out to confirm it. I don't recall. Graydon says right. Glob says right. Does not actually say if there's visible light, unfortunately. Want to buy a map, I know. Let's see. Here's what you guys have from the map. I don't know why I have to keep selecting this. All right, let's see this map. There we go. Okay, so here we go. We have, let's see, vote for right. One vote for right, two votes for right, three votes for right. Let's see, left from Wyvall. Jedi says right. Gem and Law says left. Zero says right, because we went left last time. Duranker says right. I think that is true, that right is the general consensus. There we go, there's the part of the map there. You're right down at this T-junction down here. This T-junction, Bill. Right below the chamber where you fought the Snow Witch, the White Dragon, the Treasure Chest, and the Sentinel. There's a lot going on in that chamber. All right, Dragon Spear says left. All right, so the ranker says right. The six people say right, three people say left. In a moment, I will call that. He says left. All right, six for right, four for left. Anyone else? Anyone else? Quite a bit. Good to see you, Saad. Oh, wait, that wasn't Sir. Darn it, Sertifi and Saad both start with an S and both in blue. What's up, Sertifi? Good to see you, man. For some reason, I decided to call you Saad. I have no idea why. Should take it as a compliment, though. Alright, so you guys are going to take a right. As you walk along, the elf introduces himself. My name is Red Swift, and he is known as Stub, he says, pointing to the smiling dwarf. We met here as slaves in the service of the Wild Snow Witch. We both now hope to return to our villages. I live in the Moonstone Hills, and Stub comes from Stonebridge. If we manage to escape from these infernal caverns, you're more than welcome to come and stay with us. Stonebridge is on the way to my village in the hills. It's also a long way off. Just as Red Swift is about to continue, you notice something strange about the floor, and tell them to look down. There are two pairs of parallel footsteps running down the tunnel for approximately 20 meters. One pair is painted white, and the other is painted black. You wonder why they are there, but you cannot come up with an answer. Will you walk on the white footprints, walk on the black footprints, or walk between the footprints. So what do you think, guys? Walk on the white footprints, walk in the black footprints, or walk between the footprints? Black footprints, huh? All right, I have a vote for black. Bill says black. Graydon says black. Minos says black. What's up, Minos? She's a snow witch, I'd say white. Yeah, that's true. White. All right, I got 2 votes for white, 3 votes for black. Tell somebody doesn't have a cool name like Red Swift and then walk between. Zero says between. Black says, Snark says black. All right, Wyball. Tachyon says black. Geminlaw says white. All right, 3 votes for white, 5 votes for black, 1 vote for walking between. Eric says black. Wyval says white. All right. 4 votes for white, 6 votes for black, 1 vote for between. Jedi Knight says white. This is close. Triple 20. Nice. In before hideous death. All right. This is a close one, guys. 5 votes for white. 6 votes for black. 1 vote for walk between. Very close. You have encountered a white rat. That was the thing that turned into the dragon. He said to beware the white rat, and it was right. You need to beware him. For sure. Globs is black. All right, 5 votes for white, 7 votes for black, 1 vote for between. All right, going once. Going twice. Okay. Kilobyte says white. Zerma says forever alone. I know you're alone, lonely between the footprints. It's true. This is the walking music right here. 6 votes for walk on white, 7 votes for walk on black, 1 vote for walk between. All right, so it looks like we're going with walking on the black footprints. Okay. As soon as you step onto the black footprints, you feel a strange sensation. Your whole body starts to vibrate and your legs feel so weak that you think you're about to collapse. You press on resolutely, but when you step past the final footprint, you still feel as though your body has been drained of some of its strength. Lose 1 skill point and 3 stamina points. Cursing the bewitched caverns, you press on down the tunnel. Now, so you lose 3 stamina points, you're down to 11, so you guys may need to think about provisions. The good news, however, is that you don't actually lose that 1 skill point because your sword of speed is +1 skill, so you guys are at 12, still at 12. However, if you lose skill again, you're out of luck because if you lose skill again, that's more than the sword is going to be able to handle. So you guys are still at 12, but you pretty much used up your buffer, basically. You picked black, hoping something bad would happen. Oh my gosh. Okay, so I'm assuming everyone wants to eat the provision. Is that fair to say? And also, do you guys want to eat one here and then the next entry? Because you can eat one entry. Remember, you can eat 1 provision per entry that you're not in combat. So do you want to eat 1 provision here and then the next entry without combat, eat again? That would bring you up to 19, and you'd have two provisions left. So yes? You need to step in the Talos form in the name Jehovah. Yeah. Dranker says yep, Tekken says yes, Graydon says yes. In Latin, Jehovah starts with an I. Okay. Alright, sounds good, Zermus. Alright, so you guys are gonna have one provision right now. That seems pretty clear. And it looks like, unless anyone has big objections, you guys will take another one at this very next entry, unless there's combat. The only downside to eating provisions is that you run out of provisions. That's basically it. Okay, you do have an option. Yeah, you get fat. Well, that and eventually you run out of them, but... Alright, so now you guys are up to 19 stamina, and you have two provisions. Alright. And provisions make you fat. Okay. The tunnel soon turns sharply left. As you turn the corner, you see something on the floor sparkling in the dim light. You bend down and pick up a circular metal disc. Hoping that it might be useful, you put it in your pocket. Circular metal disc. Alright. It's not long before the tunnel turns sharply left again, and you soon arrive at a junction. After some discussion, you decide to turn right rather than continue straight on. Placed against the left-hand wall of the tunnel, you see a large iron casket with a brass handle in the shape of a serpent. No one volunteers to open the casket, so you decide to draw lots. Roll one die, please, Kilobyte. Could be. Could be. It doesn't look like a coin, like a gold coin that you took out, but it's definitely there. It's definitely circular and metal, so. Okay. Four. Stub draws the short straw and reaches for the handle, cursing his luck. As soon as he touches it, it comes alive. An asp curls itself around his hand, and before he can shake it off, it sinks its poisonous fangs into his wrist. He falls onto his knees, clutching his wrist with his other hand. Red Swift quickly draws off the poison with his knife. Luckily, the dwarf has a strong constitution, and he soon recovers enough strength to continue. That would have been you that the ass bit, so, you know. Alright. The tunnel soon ends at a T-junction. Stepping into the cross passage, you almost bump into a primitive-looking man wearing furs and carrying a large stone club. He is a caveman. You draw your sword and tell Red Swift and Stub to head quickly down the right-hand tunnel while you deal with the caveman. Alright, here's the caveman, folks. This is caveman music.
Caveman.
Must be American. Here you go. Alright, so, skill 8, stamina 8. Alright, the caveman comes in with his club and rolls a 6. So, gets a 14. So you need a 2. A 2 to tie or a 3 to beat this first one around, Killbite. Captain Kerman! Alright, let's see. A 6, 14, so 3. So you do, in fact, beat it. Not by much. He grunts as your sword cuts his side and tries to come into this club. And that means that he rolls a 3. He gets an 11, so you have 1 to lose this round. So just go ahead and clear that die roll. And you get a 6, so you do in fact hit him a second time. This time he brings in his club with a more powerful hit. 17s need a 5 to tie, 6 to beat this time around. And you get a 6 to beat. What's up, Thorg? All right, the caveman looks in rough shape, drawing a ragged breath. He rolls a 7, it's 15. You need a 3 to tie, a 4 to beat. And you get a 5. Down goes the caveman. All right, the caveman is dead. A pouch on the caveman's belt contains a star-shaped metal disc, which you decide to put in your backpack. Not wishing to meet any more cavemen, you run along the tunnel to catch up with Red Swift and Stub. All right, so you have a star-shaped metal disc. So you guys have a circular metal disc and a star-shaped metal disc. You don't know what that means, but there it is. So you guys have two discs. Who knows what they are or why? All right. The tunnel ends at a door which swings open before you even touch it. You look into a star-shaped metal disc. I guess so. I guess it's like a star disc. Metal star, basically. You look into a cavern and are surprised to see Red Swift and Stub doing kneeling in submission to this. Let me show you what it is. All right, give me a second. Could be. All right, you guys see this. Oh, gosh. I think it was right, yeah. You look into a cavern and surprised to see Red Swift and Stub kneeling in submission to a horrible robed creature with an octopus-like head. Two of its tentacles are wrapped around your friends' heads, and they are trapped by the hypnotic powers of the Brain Slayer. Second here. The Brain Slayer's disgusting tentacles flail frantically as it concentrates its mental powers in an effort to draw you towards it. Unable to resist, you walk in a trance towards the hideous creature. You can only watch helplessly as it wraps one of its tentacles around your head. You feel weak and soon black out as the Brain Slayer begins to feed on your brain power. Lose 2 skill points and 6 stamina points. Sorry, 1 skill point, misread that. 1 skill point and 6 stamina points. If you are still alive, and you are. Oh my god, really, Thorg? Oh, hi, Cthulhu. Exactly. Or a mind flayer, one or the other. You wake to find Red Swift and Stub lying unconscious on the floor. There is no sign of the Brain Slayer. You groan as you try to sit up. The pain in your head is almost unbearable. Your two companions eventually come round. They are obviously suffering too. They explain that the Brain Slayer drew them into the cavern and they were powerless to resist. Now, before I go on with this description, is it fair to say that everyone wants to have one of their provisions? Does everyone want to have one of their provisions, which will bring you up to 17? Before I continue on to the description of this cavern? Yes on the provision or no? Bill says, yes, eat. Everyone else in agreement? I'm telling you, I have to find you guys this page that talks about the fighting fantasy stuff. That this guy is going through all the books. because he talks about this experience of constantly eating to improve health. Like, he just like, I drop, his thing's like, I dropped to one knee behind the dead monster, gnawing away at a turkey leg. And it was just so funny. It's like, yep. Eat. Okay, so everyone wants to eat. All right. Getting low on those provisions, guys. Only got one provision left. All right, you're up to 17. Has to give it to predict World Cup winners, I know, right? Okay. You examine the chamber and see another door opposite in the far wall. There are also two clay pots in a recess in the wall, one red and one gray. So, will you open the door, look in the red pot, or look in the gray pot? What's up, Rogan? Good to see you, man. Octodad, no one suspects a thing. Open the door, look inside the red pot, or look inside the gray pot. Tackle, yeah, it's funny. Sadly, you cannot attack the darkness. Snark says red pot. Minos says red pot. Bill says gray pot. I don't know whether you can only look in one pot or not. Let me see. You can look in both, actually. I vote red. You can look in both if you want, but you have to start with one, obviously. Kill says red. Red's my favorite color, too, actually. Tachyon says red. What's up, Lakota? Gray. Red, because red is the color of health. All right, see you later, Graydon. Thanks, dude. Open the door. All right, I got 5 votes for red pot, 2 votes for gray pot, 1 vote for open the door. Duranker says gray. Look in the gray, red, because red is the color of blood. Thorax is red. Wyvol says gray. Red things usually explode. All right, 6 votes for red, 4 votes for gray, 1 vote for open the door. Going once. Going twice. And... okay. Red pot it is. Jedi Nut says red pot. In which case, silver is bad, according to what happened tonight. Okay, red pot it is. There's no green pot, sadly, no. Very funny, though. Lying at the bottom of the red pot is a square metal disc, which you decide to put in your backpack. So a third one of these discs. So you now have a circular one, a star-shaped one, and a square one. Actually, even though I think this is the British spelling... Alright, so square metal disc you decide to put in your backpack. So now, do you wish to look inside the gray pot or leave by the other door? So you looked inside the red pot, now you're going to look inside the gray pot. So you can now look in the gray pot if you wish. Gotta catch them all, Discamon, I know, right? Look in the gray pot. Snark says gray pot. Welcome, by the way, to everybody who's new in here. We got to 46 people now. That's great to see all of you. I hope you like what you see in here. My name is Arvin Elleron. We are playing Caverns of the Snow Witch, which we are concluding today. It's dangerous to go alone. Take this. I know, right, Thorg? I'm thinking about Tron, too. Gray pot. Make one of the other two look in the gray pot. Sadly, not an option. I think Stub has already, like, had enough with the poison, etc. Duranker says door. Tron 2 or Tron 2? Tron. I wasn't actually thinking of Tron 2, but Tron 2. Yeah, it's good stuff, Bill. The tabletop stuff. Okay, so it looks like people are pretty strongly in favor of looking inside the gray pot. Alright. Okay, so you look inside the gray pot. Lying at the bottom of the gray pot is an old parchment scroll with an unbroken wax seal. Do you wish to break the seal and read the scroll? Or open that door? So... So you found the parchment in there with a seal. So break the seal and open the scroll. They could be Tron Deadly Discs. There you go. That's what I'm talking about. Dragon says scroll. No more info on the seal, Bill, just that it is sealed. Scroll, Lakotus's door. It just says an unbroken wax seal. All right. Discs of Tron. Yeah, I have that on Intellivision. I had Tron Deadly Discs. Want to buy more scrutiny, I know. I mean, it definitely, you know, it's a parchment that you can pick up without hurting yourself anyway. It definitely is not burning your fingers or something. All right, Duranker says scroll. I've been wrong all night, that's funny. Came this far, may as well open the scroll. Arcade sounding like he's doing a YOLO strats. Because Game Logic opened the scroll. All right. 5 votes for open the scroll, 2 votes for the door. Okay, going once, going twice. All right, as soon as you begin reading the scroll, the writing starts to fade. Roll 2 dice. So roll 2 dice, please, and tell me what the number is. Kilobyte, please. Okay, so I got to read the scroll. Alright, so we got 6 for read the scroll, so it looked like people were in favor of it. So yeah, so roll those 2 dice, please. Open everything! Alright. Because it was less than your skill, before the writing fades away, you learn a spell which will protect you against an attack by an air elemental. Add 1 luck point. Now, you can't do that because you're maxed out on luck, but... You memorize the words, Gul Sang Abi Dar. So, let's see. Let me fix that. Okay, goal. Yep. Gul Sang Abi Dar. Alright, so you have a thing to defeat air elementals. Alright, well done. See, guys, it was fine. I don't know why you guys would think that opening up and putting on everything ever goes against you. Where could that have gone wrong? okay, so now you guys leave by the door opposite. The door opens into yet another tunnel, and you begin to wonder whether you will ever find your way out of the caverns of the Snow Witch. You look at Red Swift and Stub, but they do not appear to be very concerned. The tunnel soon ends at another door, and you notice a dagger sticking out of its oak paneling. Do you wish to pull the dagger out of the door, or open the door? Do you wish to pull the dagger out of the door, or open the door? There you go, Royce. That's a gray area. That's funny. dagger, dagger, dagger. If you open an Elder Scroll, you go blind. I know. And then you try forging a sword, even though you're blind, apparently. Because Skyrim logic. Dagger. Minos says open the door. Dagger, 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 dagger. Minos says open the door. Okay, four for dagger. Wyvil also says open the door. Four for dagger, two for open the door. Lakota says open the door. Durangar says open the door. All right, 4-4. What are those cheesy choices? Cheesy choices are pull the dagger out of the door or just open the door. Those are the choices that await you. Leave it and open the door, Kilobyte says. All right. So we got 5 votes for open the door, 4 votes for dagger. Well, you already have a dagger, or you had one. You already have a dagger, actually, Rogan. So it looks like you guys are opening the door. All right. Okay. The door opens into another tunnel, which leads off into the distance. Stub begins to complain about being tired and hungry, so you decide to sit down and rest. Now, it's interesting. It says, if you still have 3 portions of provisions, you eat one yourself and give 1 each to Red Swift and Stub. Since you don't have the 3 portions, I'm just going to assume that you guys just have your 1 remaining provision. So, you're maxed out on stamina. You have no provisions left, because that's what the book tells you to do. But that's what it is, so that's fine. And the door... Okay, so Rogan also went with that. Okay, cool. So, no provisions, but you're at max health. That's it, guys. No, now you just have to hope that you can find health if you need it, if you start losing it. Okay, after resting for half an hour, you set off again, and eventually the tunnel ends at a T-junction. Now the question is, do you wish to go left, or do you wish to go right? So again, left or right. Not given a provision. We could always eat the dwarf. Delicious. Dwarves are a little gamey, I think. Left, almighty left. Left. Left! What's up, EXT? Good to see you, man. That's funny, Jedi. That's really funny. Oh, man. Okay, Minos is right. 3 votes for left. Every dungeon should have a center path. Adventurers never go to the center. I know. Although, actually, Rogan, you guys did go into the skull mouth in the illusionist room, and that was center. No option to go back the way we came, sadly, Snark. A little late for that, anyway. Alright, going left. 4 for left. Lefty Lucy. Demiser, because there is no Caverns of the Snow Witch option. That's why. If there was a Caverns of the Snow Witch option, I'd totally be all over it. But sadly, there is not. I'm sorry to say. So, Warlock is the closest that they got. Yeah, actually, Death Trap Dungeon is in there, too, but But Death Trap Dungeon also can be confused with a computer game, so that's basically why. Okay, so you guys are going left. All right. Left it is. The tunnel soon comes to a dead end. An ornate shield hangs from an iron nail on the end wall. Do you wish to take the shield or turn around and walk the other way? So, take shield or not. Take shield. The music in the background is Final Fantasy VI, Thorg. Called Balance and Ruin. It's an overclocked remix, and it's amazing. I love it. Okay. So let's see. So we've got, take the shield. Take the shield, take the shield, take the shield, take the shield. And then we've got, walk away and walk away. So we've got 5 for take the shield. I'd Shazam it, but Arv keeps talking. Sorry, Thorg. Oh, man. Take shield, take shield, take shield, take shield, take shield. Decisions, decisions, yeah. Well, you know. But see, I think he does that very well because there was the other time where you guys took everything and everything was good to take. So sometimes he does that and sometimes he doesn't. He's very, throws it around. YOLO! Yes, it's a good point. You make a good point. Okay. All right, so we have 5 votes for shield, 2 votes for go. Let's see, 5 votes for shield, 3 votes for go back. Okay, shield, the Avengers must be nearby. I know Captain America's right around the corner. Alright, so you guys have decided to take the shield. As soon as you touch the shield, a howling wind starts to blow down the tunnel towards you, almost knocking the 3 of you off your feet.
You have no power here, Demiser the Grey.
Anyway, then almost knocking the 3 of you off your feet. Then you see a whirlwind coming down the tunnel, gathering up all rocks and stones in its path. Chat, do the words Gulsang Abidar mean anything to you? Do the words Gulsang Abidar mean anything to you? Do they? Do they mean anything to you? Fortunately, some people in chat do remember that they mean something for you. Yes, that is in fact what you just learned from that scroll that you read. Taking the shield has unleashed the fury of an air elemental. Fortunately, you remember the words on the scroll and utter them as the elemental draws near. It disappears as quickly as it appeared, and all is calm again. You sling the shield onto your arm, add 1 skill point. Well, maybe I didn't say every single solitary syllable exactly right, but basically I said them, yeah. That gets you guys back up to 12. All right, gets you back up to your skill of 12. All right, you sling the shield onto your arm, add one skill point, and walk together back down the tunnel and past the last junction. All right, so you go back to the other place and go back the other direction. Ta-da! Chattavarada necktie. The tunnel ends at another door. An old piece of parchment is pinned on it. There is faded writing on the parchment, but you do not understand the language. Knowing that elves speak many languages, you ask Red Swift to try to read it. As he reads, his eyes widen with terror. You ask him what is wrong, but he refuses to reply. He rips the parchment off the door and tears it into tiny pieces. He turns the door handle and says, "Let's get going. There's no time to lose." You and Stubb look at each other and shrug your shoulders, deciding simply to obey the troubled Red Swift. The door opens into another tunnel. After walking down it for a few meters, you come to a place where water is dripping down continuously from stalactites overhead. Do you have a shield, chat? God, I love this album. Do you guys have a shield? Klaatu Barata Nikto. Yes, indeed. Yes, you do have a shield. Yes, you do. The water looks harmless enough, but you do not wish to get cold and wet. You place the shield over your head and walk under the gentle waterfall. You throw the shield back for your companions to use, and you are soon on your way again. The tunnel runs straight on until it opens out into a cavern. The walls are covered with ice, and a large glass globe stands on an ice plinth in the center. Suddenly, an orc runs into the cavern from the tunnel opposite, and the globe immediately starts to radiate light. The outline of a face takes shape in the globe, one which you recognize. The Snow Witch! Her encased head starts to laugh, and then you hear her speak. In a chilling voice, she says, "Although you killed me, you have not defeated me. My spirit can still defeat you. Watch carefully." The orc, who is standing by the globe, grips the metal collar around his neck and cries out, gasping for breath. His green face bulges as he desperately tries to stop the collar tightening. His efforts are futile and he soon falls silently to the floor. The Snow Witch's image sneers contemptuously and says, "I have no use for servants any longer, and I know that two of you are still wearing my obedience collars. I will enjoy watching you die next as a forerunner to the agony I have in store for your impudent warrior friend." You refuse to watch Red Swift and Stubb die helplessly, and you rack your brain to think of a way to overcome the spirit of the Snow Witch. Will you, number one, try to smash this globe with your sword? Two, fire an iron ball from your sling at the globe if you have one, and in fact you have two of them. Or three, try to run through the cavern into the opposite tunnel. So, smash globe with sword. Or fire. Charles Lee, nice Thorg, nice. This isn't even my final form! Alright, what's it gonna be? Smash the globe with a sword, fire iron ball from the sling at the globe, or run through the cavern to the opposite tunnel. Throw the fish at her. Okay, Arcade says, fire the sling. Fire the sling. Snark says, fire an iron ball. Lakota says, run. Bill says, sling the iron ball. Kill says, sling. Tackin says, iron balls. Time to whip out the balls. Run, we owe those two nothing. Minos. Those two don't have anything. Okay, iron ball. We've got balls of steel. Balls of Iron does not have the same ring to it. It's a globe of what? It seems to be, you can't really tell. It's clear. Welcome back, Zermus. It seems to be clear, Rogan, but